a call for an uprising. Welcome to today's show. 1984 is becoming a reality day in and day out. And now we're seeing Google. I mean, this is something you'd think would be fake news, but Google is building a futuristic neighborhood in Toronto. Now people are going to say, well, what's wrong with that? Why is that such a problem? Why does that have something to do with the New World Order? Well, I'll tell you why. Because I'll tell you some of the things that they plan on doing with this thing called Sidewalk Labs, which is an urban innovation company owned by Google's parent company. And they're investing $50 million in an initial phase of planning and pilot testing. They're actually calling this, get this, a laboratory. And now, what is the definition of a laboratory? It is a room or building equipped for scientific experiments, research, or teaching, or for the manufacture of drugs or chemicals. So in other words, they're going to be performing this experiment on the people of Toronto, of course, with the help of Justin Trudeau, who we don't even need to get into that guy and his New World Order ties and him and the agendas that he pushes up there on the Canadian people. But get this, what they're openly going to do here and what they're openly talking about. Sidewalk Labs plans to do everything from reduce pollution to reducing commute time. So they want to make sure that you get to your job on time, right? Make sure you're always there on time to be a slave for them. But this is where it's funny. And to reduce landfill waste, to improve the weather, it envisions reducing the impact of wind, increasing shade on sunny days, and blocking rain due to smart building design and tree planting. So they'll be doing what they can to automate the weather, wink, wink. But remember, they don't actually control the weather. They don't have technology to manipulate the weather. And this is Google. This is the future, folks. And you know what else this laboratory, this test experiment is going to have? Well, it's going to have self-driving taxis and buses. That's right, Sidewalk proposes taxi bots as the transportation backbone of the neighborhood. Small self-driving cars controlled by app-based services such as Waymo and Lyft. Larger self-driving buses would be the next larger scale, and the company proposes piloting that technology early in the project. So this is another thing where people just don't seem to get the bigger picture. They go, well, what's wrong with self-driving cars? What's wrong with, the technology just continuing to advance? Because people think this stuff is good. They're like, oh, it's great. You know, we have robots that can do jobs 10 times faster than humans. Well, for starters, you can say goodbye to your jobs. And two, you could probably say goodbye to our existence. Because we're only here to serve them in their minds. That's what we're here for. And when they don't need us anymore, and they have the artificial intelligence doing everything, we become expendable, and we already are. I mean, they really don't need us as it is. They can't stand us. But cars that drive themselves, you know how much freedom you're giving up? For starters, you couldn't pay me to get in a car with no driver, okay? Because I'm sure I'd likely be somebody who had a quote-unquote accident. You know, I get in the car, and all of a sudden it would drive off a cliff. Ooh, cliff, oops. Call for an uprising. His car drove off. It's been a tough... You know, it was a bad car, the app went haywire. I mean, you're giving them total control of where you're going, access to where you're going, even though they have that with GPSs on the phones and tracking devices monitoring us. But you can get in a car thinking you're going to the mall, and you could end up in a warehouse somewhere where someone shoots you in the back of the head. I mean, think of the control you're giving up. But people think this is good. They've been pushing this with millennials and how millennials don't want to drive. Millennials think it's too difficult to carry a wallet around. It'd be better to have a microchip, right? This is all the stuff they're pushing. Cashless society. These are all New World Order agendas. Now, you could even see the coding, which is kind of just, you know, it's always there. When we talk about this stuff, when I talk about it, when others talk about it, they always are using their basic coding to let everybody know who's really behind this experiment, so to speak. And that's why this initiative is going to include 3.3 million square feet of residential office and commercial space, including a new headquarters for Google Canada, in a district that would be a test bed for the combination of technology and urbanism. So it's a test experiment. In other words, everybody involved in this area is just going to be a lab rat for them. They're going to test all this stuff on you. Who knows what else is going to be. I mean, I can guarantee you this city will have some chemtrails flying above it, that's for sure. But 3.3 million square feet. I mean, the mockery just never stops. What else will they have? Well, they're going to have garbage robots. Yes, garbage robots. Industrial robots moving in an underground network of utility tunnels, which would manage the collection of trash and recyclables. And people are going to go, that's great. Boy, we don't have to worry about, somebody throwing a Coke can in the trash can. Who cares the crap that's going on? People are worried about throwing a glass bottle in a trash bag. Oopsies. The environment's going to really hurt over that. Meanwhile, they're dumping aluminum on us every day, giving people Alzheimer's, sticking needles in our kids, these vaccinations that are causing autism to spiral out of control. They're also going to have an app developed by the sidewalk company called Flow. Sidewalk would pilot a program that keeps parking prices high, but offers discounts to people who are coming from areas or at times when transit options are limited. Technology will enable pricing to vary in real time based on transit availability. So they're just letting you know they're still gonna screw you on parking fees in this updated robotic Google city. Don't worry about it. We'll still stick it to you where it hurts in your wallet. They're gonna have deeply flexible buildings. You can see some of the images of this futuristic city, and I know people are gonna go, this is great, this architect's wonderful. You know, weather, look at this, I mean, the stuff with weather manipulation, arranging buildings carefully to produce comfortable microclimates. The company suggests it could double the time in which it is comfortable to be outside in Toronto's climate. So they wanna experiment on these people too, to make sure that all this stuff makes them get to work on time, enjoy work more because, oh, there's more shade or the weather's more comfortable, so that they could be happy while they're slaving away for their handlers inside of the Matrix. Flexible, walkable streets. Sidewalks with a heavily pedestrianized district. The company calls for narrow streets that privilege the pedestrian and an intimate human scale. I mean, what is this stuff necessary? You know, they talk about how people are evolving. I always say we're devolving, we're going backwards, we're going in reverse. This is some of the most pointless crap that they dump money into and then openly say, hey, you guys are going to be test rats, lab rats for us. Okay? And people go, sure, great. There's going to be shaded areas in this city? Yup. There's going to be cars that drive themselves? Sure are. Great. Did you say something about being a test rat? Yeah, don't worry about it. Okay, cool. Let me get in my car that is going to take me where I ask it to take me. And I won't worry about any consequences. I won't worry about giving up all my personal information. I won't worry about any of that stuff. I'll just go along with it. Just make sure I get to work on time and make sure, you know, that you control the size of the building so there's more shade in the city. And this is what money gets pumped into, nonsense like this. Not to mention some of the other stuff that Google's got going on right now, including this frightening AI that Google has unveiled, which is capable and able to create knowledge itself, saying it's a major breakthrough for AI intelligence. AlphaGo Zero took just 3 days to master the ancient Chinese board game of Go with no human help. So, I mean, people look at this and they go, that's great. Yeah, it's great. I mean, let's look at the predictive programming with Terminator and all these other movies with robots taking over. I mean, it's unbelievable. The transhumanism agenda, I mean, it's all going on. And people are just, like, applauding it. Google's artificial intelligence group, DeepMind, has unveiled this incarnation of its Go-playing program, AlphaGo, an AI so powerful that it derived thousands of years of human knowledge of the game before inventing better moves of its own. All in the space of 3 days. I mean, this is what's going on around us. Google is controlling this stuff. pushing this stuff forward, futuristic cities where people are going to go, oh, it's great, it's wonderful. Where, you know, cars, human drivers are taken away, where it's all, everything is robotically done. Humans don't have a purpose anymore. People are going to want to become half robots and go with this transhumanism agenda. It's all right in front of our faces. They're rubbing it in. They're saying, look, we've created a robot that can teach, you know, that didn't even need to be taught how to play this game. It learned it on its own, and it's now writing, you know, code or whatever strategy that's better than any human has ever come up with. This is Google taking over, 1984 style, folks. So if you're in Toronto, you might want to stay clear of this experiment. That's for sure. But the masses out there will ask for this in their cities and say, this is great. I can get to work on time. Make my commute 5 minutes faster. It's all worth it. Stick the microchip in me. Make me part robot so I can be superhuman, not realizing I've been programmed my whole life to want to be like Superman or any of these loser superheroes that they push out day in and day out. Ant-Man. I mean, has anyone seen some of this nonsense? And people are like, who's your favorite superhero? The only superhero that ever existed was Jesus Christ. The rest of these things, this is all programming for everybody to want to be more, to want to be mixed with robots and machines, and to live in cities controlled by Google, manipulated by Google, which are going to monitor you 24/7. And don't worry, just because they're saying you're going to be a rat in a lab experiment, don't worry about it, you know? Oh, that's not what they mean. Sure. Don't be surprised if they start vaccinating people in these cities every time they go to work every day. Oh, you need a vaccination when you come in through the front door every day to make sure you don't give anyone else a cold. Oh, okay, I'll take it. What's in it? Just stuff that helps you, like, you know, vitamin C. Okay, great. Here's your shot. Hope you enjoy Alzheimer's in a few years. Welcome to the New World Order, folks. Thank you for listening to today's show. God bless all of you and your families.